It's Bloody Idiot of the Week. Welcome back, idiot fans. My name's Dave Donovan from Independent Australia, and once again, I'll be guiding you through the biggest streaming hot mess this side of the Australian parliamentary question time. Enough of that. Hold your nose as we dive straight into the shallow end of the gene pool. First up, barely dipping her toes in the DNA waiting pool, is infamous Gold Coast real estate speculator and part-time federal minister Susan Scattergun Lay, or is that Lee, commenting on the ABC about the eden-monaro by-election.
What a desperate situation for Labor to be relying on preferences from this party to perhaps get them over the line in a by-election that they should, by their own reckoning, have been well in front of. Contrasting the Prime Minister with Anthony Albanese's strong leadership, but if he's such a strong leader, Christina, why doesn't he appear on any of your handouts at the booths? So we've got a clear statement on our handout to voters, but at the same time you're suggesting tonight that yes, he's the man, but you spent more time mentioning a disgraced Labor leader member in Victoria that absolutely has nothing to do with this seat. But what it comes down to is that this is a disastrous result for Labor tonight. It is really, really shocking.
A disaster for the Labor Party? Oh no! Just imagine how catastrophic it would have been if Labor had actually lost. We are the champions, my friends. Susan Lee, Lay, whatever your name is, you filly scatterbrain. Next up is the Murdoch Mafia's latest hero, so-called reform climate activist, Michael, Schellenberger. Never heard of him? Who has?
Well, I've been working on environmental issues for a really long time. 33 years as an environmental activist. I've been a climate activist for 20 years, and I know the science well enough to know that climate change is not a catastrophic threat. And you know, adolescents these days, they have a lot of things to worry about. Anxiety and depression are rising among everybody, really, but certainly among adolescents. And I thought it was not right to be terrorizing, you know, school children.
Oh, why won't people stop terrorizing the poor widow kiddiewinkles? Except, wait, it turns out Schellenberger hasn't been a climate activist, if he ever was, since at least 2010. Oh, but he's an activist, a radio activist. That's right, he's a shill for the nuclear industry, even missiles, apparently.
I felt emboldened that I needed to speak out, and I think that the majority of scientists are not activists. There's actually just a handful of scientists that feel the need to terrify people.
Michael Schellenberger, clean and brightly glowing green. But enough of these amateur imbeciles. Now for some experts. Like former PM Tony Abbott, claiming that there is no evidence of discrimination in the justice system against Indigenous Australians. Yes, there's only been 423 Indigenous deaths in custody since the Royal Commission handed down its report in 1991. To think that raw, brown, unpeeled onion eater has just received an Order of Australia for his service in Indigenous affairs. Idiots! And now for everyone's favourite part of the show, where Prime Minister Scott Morrison says something so stupid that you can actually feel your IQ decrease just by listening to him.
Women from the Yass Valley are currently forced to travel an hour to Canberra or Goulburn to give birth. As a result, a number of women have been forced to give birth on the side of the Barton Highway. Does the Prime Minister agree that that is unacceptable?
The Prime Minister has the call.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Well, I'm pleased to let the member know that's why we've committed $150 million to upgrade the Barton Highway, which includes the duplication
members on my left
of the highway.
Ladies and gentlemen, I feel like we have a winner. Scott Morrison, you are this week's Bloody Idiot of the Week. And a big thanks to all you idiot fans for making this week's idiot possible. As always, remember to like, subscribe, comment, share and visit Independent Australia for reliable updates on the massive doofoids who run our nation. See you next week. What are you doing here? The video's finished. Oh, you wanna subscribe or donate to Independent Australia? Well, you can do that here. This is how you subscribe. And if you want to donate, then, you know, the more zeros, the better. This is the way you do that. Catch you later. That's it.